What's up, YouTube? Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for clicking on this video today. I have not been on YouTube. I haven't posted anything to YouTube in a while. 2020 has been what it's been for everybody. It's been a good year. It's been a busy year, but it's been a challenging year. So I have not really put a lot of effort into YouTube. I was focusing on some other things, but I invested in a camera and I plan on coming out with some content regularly. So today's video to kind of kick everything off, it's gonna be a full day of eating. I'm on vacation this week, so it's not gonna be working or anything like that. And I'm just gonna be showing you my food and kind of just going through my day. So it's like the holidays, it's about right around Christmas. Today's the 29th of December. I just wanna preface this by saying I'm not showing you what I'm eating. I'm telling you this is what you need to eat. I like to watch these videos because it gives me some ideas that I can start to implement. So that's kind of my whole purpose here, is to just give you some ideas, but know that everybody is different and every body is different, and what is best for me isn't necessarily what's going to be best for you. And yeah, we're gonna start this video at this morning when I woke up, and I don't look nearly as put together as I do now. But anyway, before we get into the video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up if you enjoy it, and subscribe to my channel if you'd like to see some more of my content. I'm a personal trainer, so I'm going to be putting out a lot of fitness-focused content. So yeah, I hope you enjoy the video, and thank you for watching.
Today, and I'm gonna be starting the day as usual. It's like 7:30 in the morning. I'm getting a later start than I would typically like to. I'm on vacation this week, by the way, so I'm not gonna be like working or anything, but still I wanted to get up at like 6, but I slept, could not get my butt out of bed. So I've got my cup of water, which is already like halfway gone, and I made a cup of coffee, which I'm gonna take downstairs with me to the treadmill and get some of my steps in, get my body moving before the kids wake up. Have some goals this year, not physique-wise, but running-wise. I have some goals this year, which I'll get into at some point in this video or another video. But yeah, so that's gonna be the first thing I do, and this is typically what I do in the morning anyway. Like, I get my coffee, I get my water, I head right down to the treadmill, and I watch like Netflix or YouTube on the treadmill for like 20-30 minutes. If I have more time, I'll spend more time there, because it's like, if I'm just gonna be sitting in bed or sitting on the couch, then I might as well just have my butt moving and get some steps in and watch YouTube on the treadmill. Why not, you know? And this is my me time. This is kind of my time to myself before I start the day, and it really just puts me in a really good headspace. So that is what we're gonna do, so come along with me.
Okay, don't mind my mess of a basement, and the lighting down here is horrible, but I just wanted to show you. So we've got my treadmill here. We're working on putting together a little bit of a home gym. We've got some, I actually have more dumbbells, but I've got some dumbbells here. I think those are the 15 pounds. I've got a slam ball, and then I just picked my husband up this pull-up rack for Christmas. So it is nice because we've got the pull-up rack. We've got like the leg lift part of it, and then I can use it for my bands and stuff, and I can attach it. I just need to find something to like maybe mount it down with for some of the exercises, but we have that. And then we need to set this up, but we've got a plyo box, so we're gonna set that up. And my basement is seriously, it's crazy, but I've got a pair of 20 pound dumbbells and a kettlebell. We're end of our gym setup at the moment. We want to get an air bike, and we're currently like working on getting rid of all the kids' toys and everything. Literally everything in that whole section is gonna go, and then everything, pretty much everything over here is gonna go. So once that happens, that's gonna open up this whole space. We're gonna do something with the floors. We're gonna paint the walls. Like, it's gonna look nice down here once we get rid of everything. Meal number one, we are gonna make some breakfast wraps. So I've got my honey wheat fiber one wraps. We're gonna grab a couple of eggs. I'm gonna make 2 scrambled eggs, throw some cheese in it, and some chicken sausage. And that is going to be the first meal. Sadly, I burnt my sausage. 2 of them are for me, 2 of them are for the kids. And I burnt them. I put them in the air fryer/convection oven and put them in for too long. My mistake.
Voila.
There is my breakfast. I warmed up the wrap a little bit so that the cheese would melt. I've got the cheese at the bottom. I've got two eggs scrambled with some salt. I'm actually going to add a little bit of pepper. Although, actually, no, because this sausage is pretty spicy. So, I actually won't need to add pepper. So, I just cut it up, throw it together, I'll wrap it. And that's gonna be my breakfast.
I just wanna speak to parents right now because I have two kids and you know, it's a lot of work. Sometimes there's a lot of moving pieces and the days can get very chaotic and it can be really hard to get anything done. I had my niece and nephew yesterday and originally when I went into the day, I was like, man, this is gonna be a lot of work. I don't know how I'm gonna get meals cooked, make time to work out. I don't know how I'm gonna, whatever. But I also remembered that, like, I'm the one in charge. I'm the parent, I'm the aunt. I'm gonna make sure things go as I want them to go. And that's how the day went. I got up in the morning and I can't speak to having a routine in place enough. Having some sort of routine, having a plan for your day, at least understanding, hey, this is when I'm gonna get my activity and this is when we're gonna move, this is when I'm gonna work out, this is what we're gonna have for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Like having some sort of base plan that you can just kind of adjust as you need to, but you get up in the morning, like I know what time my kids are getting up, I control that. I tell them when it's time to get up, I tell them when it's time to go to bed because I have my own priorities. And if I let them run things, then nothing would ever get done. You know, I know what time they're getting up. I know, okay, I like to give myself a couple hours to have time to myself, to just kind of wake up, have my coffee, get on the treadmill, walk for a bit, get a workout in if I need to. No matter how many kids you can have one kid, you can have six kids. It's always gonna be crazy, it's always gonna be chaotic, but ultimately, you know, we have to make our health a priority and we have to make, you know, the things we have to do a priority or it's never gonna get done. So if it's important to you, you know that you can do it. Being a parent doesn't mean that you can't. You can make it all happen, you can. It's just gonna take a little bit of strategy and a little bit of persistence to get up in the morning or do the stuff at night before before you go to bed. And it gets easier. Now I don't even think twice about it. Like this is my routine. My routine is to get up and walk on the treadmill, right? Like, this is my routine and I enjoy it. It wasn't easy at first, but now it's just like, I don't even have to think about it. It's just what I do. So it gets easier and you can do it.
How do you like your food?
Good.
Yeah? How's yours, Gray?
Good.
Got nothing else to say? That's it?
That's it.
That's it. Okay. You got anything else to say?
Okay. They're almost there. Are you coming in? You were almost there.
So I got this new like espresso stovetop thing that a friend was telling me about and I made coffee yesterday. And I made it way too strong, like way too strong to the point where I was like, well, I'll save this to do iced coffee. But even with a load of ice and I just add a little bit more creamer to it, it's still like pure black coffee tasting.
Jesus, Mary Joseph in the camp.
Having a coffee, gonna eat something again pretty soon. Okay, so meal number two, not really even a meal. I was making the kids their lunch and I was making peanut butter and jelly. And while I don't like jelly, we have white bread and I haven't had white bread in a while. So I made myself, it's about a tablespoon of peanut butter and this piece of bread's like 60 calories. So this is literally like a pre-lunch snack of like 130 calories. I don't care. I wanted a peanut butter sandwich. So that's what I'm gonna have as like my pre-lunch and then I'm gonna make a salad for lunch, a chicken salad, so I'll show you what I'm making.
Okay, meal number two, this is my lunch. I mixed it all together, which I probably should have done that, but we've got chicken. I did one chicken breast. I've got about a quarter cup of cashews in there, less than a quarter cup of cheese. I didn't even use that much. I really only sprinkled on a little. And I've got like half of a cucumber somewhere in there.
Right around Christmas, I was getting like a million packages coming in from everywhere because I was ordering a lot of Christmas presents, but I was also kind of splurging a few things on myself. And my husband kept joking, like, okay, when are we gonna stop getting the packages coming in? And I told him that after Christmas was over, I wouldn't be getting anything else in. I got another package in.
And can we just say that These are awesome. Like, I think I paid $35 for them, and they're a no-name brand, but I love the fabric. I love they're very, like, flexible, and I ordered a 7.5, and that's usually my size. They're actually a little bit big. They slide right on and off, which is fine because I'm just going to be training. I'll do, like, my lifts in these. I'm not wearing these outside, and then be doing, like, sessions in them and teaching classes.
I can't wait to see the look on his face when I show him my new shoes. But I don't feel bad about this because, one, I have about $300 worth of stuff that I'm returning. And, two, I've been looking at Noble shoes, if you've ever heard of the brand. And those shoes are like $160. These ones are $35. So, I mean, I just saved myself $130. That's my money that I'm spending. So, I think I still have a few more packages that are supposed to come in this week, too.
I'm having some french fries, and then I'm doing some barbecue. I don't think I'm gonna eat all of this. This is way more than I thought I was. I'll probably eat like 3/4 of the chicken. And then I'm having an apple with it because I feel like I need something healthy. Not my typical dinner. Usually I'll have like one of these components, and I'll have like a side of a starchy vegetable and like a green vegetable. But today, this is what I wanted. I'm gonna have a bowl of vegetables for dinner because it's like 3 o'clock, so it's kind of a weird time, but I'm gonna have a bowl of vegetables for dinner later, and that's basically gonna be it for the rest of the day. Christmas tree, have a happy holiday. Everyone dancing merrily. It's really weird. So today is like December 27th, and usually, like December 26th, they stop playing Christmas music. Maybe because of everything going on this year, they're extending it. I think it's kind of nice. It is like 10 after 8 right now, a little after I have to get going because I'm meeting at 8:30. I'm meeting a friend and we're gonna go for a walk slash hike. I say walk slash hike because we're walking some of it and we're hiking some of it. It's kind of a little bit of both. The trails are easy and like moderate, but it's a 7.5 mile hike, so it's gonna take us probably between 2 and 3 hours. If we really hustle, we can get it done, you know, closer to the 2.5 mile mark. Let's go for a hike. Got home. We ended up not doing 7.5 miles because we got like a foot of snow like a couple weeks ago, and then on Christmas we got a bunch of rain. So not only did the foot of snow melt, but then we got a lot of rain on top of it, and the lake was like completely flooded. So like I would say we did like 3.5 miles of the 7.5, but the other, we couldn't get around the whole lake because there was just so much flooding. But I went to Dunkin' Donuts. I picked up a coffee, which this is interesting. They put this like little stopper on it. And I don't know if it's like supposed to keep it from leaking, or the coffee tastes like garbage, so I'm gonna hopefully be able to fix that once I get inside with some creamer. And then I picked up some donuts for the kids. I had a half of a maple frosted donut. I was gonna eat the whole thing, and then I figured I would save the other half for Chris if he wants it. So
we're about to head out for our walk, having a quick shot. Chris was supposed to wait for me, but he didn't, so. Cheers. Smooth.
Oh, when we get back.
Another one.
No, I didn't say for sure. There's nothing. This is all dry last time.